Europe needs to get its act together when it comes to dealing with migrants and asylum seekers. That's what the UN refugee chief Filippo Grandi said earlier today. Now, currently, European rules state that migrants need to seek asylum at the first point of entry. Often that's countries like Italy, for instance. This, he says, places a lot of the burden on coastal countries. Listen.
Europe has to get its act together on these issues anyway. You know, the Dublin principles that everybody has to go and seek asylum in the first country in Europe in which they enter was perhaps okay 20 years ago when there were few people, but is completely inadequate now. So Europe has to have a new system that is based more on sharing, on responsibility sharing.
Well, the European Commission had proposed a quota-style system to ease the burden on the frontline countries, but the idea has been blocked by several countries who refuse to take in their share of refugees and asylum seekers. That trip to Europe can be dangerous, and now some of the aid workers who are trying to save migrants at sea are being prosecuted for doing so. Simon Cullen has the details.
In different circumstances, these rescuers might have been considered heroes.
First ladies, children, okay?
Pulling migrants from dangerously overcrowded boats as they made their way towards the Greek island of Lesbos.
We had two search and rescue boats, we had scuba equipment, we had a very well-trained medical team which could respond within 7 minutes, whereas the ambulance sometimes trundled along at 40 minutes.
So the difference is life or death for some people?
It can be.
But rather than being celebrated, they're being charged. Sean Binder is facing a string of serious accusations in Greece.
Being part of a criminal organization, money laundering, obviously tantamount to smuggling, our actions are tantamount to smuggling, and espionage or spying. And so we still face centuries in prison.
He's not alone. In June, the captain of the Sea Watch rescue ship, Carola Rackett, was arrested by Italian authorities after docking on the island of Lampedusa.
We unfortunately didn't have any other option than to enter the port without permission.
On board were 40 migrants who'd been rescued from the Mediterranean. Rackett was later released from arrest, but still faces an ongoing investigation under anti-people smuggling laws, laws enabled by an EU directive.
The 2002 directive was designed to combat people smuggling. It allows countries to prosecute anyone helping someone else enter Europe illegally. It doesn't require there to be a financial motive, and the humanitarian exemption clause is only optional, meaning countries can choose whether or not they enact it.
Over recent years, the number of migrants arriving by sea has been falling. At the same time, according to EU-funded research, there's been an increase in the number of criminal investigations targeting aid workers and NGOs.
We're criminalising human beings, helping other human beings being in need. And that just plainly needs to stop.
As a result of the crackdown, there are now fewer rescue ships operating on the Mediterranean, a region that has claimed the lives of nearly 20,000 migrants in the past 6 years. In a statement to CNN, the European Commission acknowledges there is a lack of clarity in the implementation of the humanitarian exemption clause and says it'll continue to gather more evidence about how the directive is being applied.
The case has been made to them that these prosecutors are in large part trumped up and they shouldn't happen at all. I think they are not convinced yet that this is a sufficiently serious problem to warrant the change of the directive.
Rescuers warn if it's not changed, the criminal charges will continue.
The effect has been to embroil us in costly and lengthy legal procedures, and this acts as a form of deterrence. It has frightened people away from doing this kind of work, and this is work that is sanctioned by international law without a doubt.
A situation, he says, that will result in more deaths at sea.